Every 2 weeks, another language goes extinct. Could translation devices save them? One thing we have to understand about communication is that messages don't really travel, they code. Take a look at this model. First, you have to encode the message, like in a language, and then it has to travel through some channel, such as the airwaves, then it has to be received, and then decoded. That means there's a lot of places where communication can get a little mucked up. Now, I wonder if our progress has allowed us to communicate more effectively. After all, since the printing press, we've gone all the way to the smartphone with lots of communication revolutions along the way. So, what's next? Well, what about translation devices that allow people to communicate across language barriers? Here's how it would work. You're in a foreign country and you want to greet a local. You speak into a device, like a mobile phone, and speech recognition software digitizes the sound and uses statistical algorithms to guess what was said. The algorithm also takes context into account so that the relationship of words affects the computer's guess. During the translation phase, an algorithm compares your words and phrases to troves of translated documents and web pages from the local language and makes another guess at the translation. It then uses a library of speech sounds to produce your sentence in the local language. Real-time translation already exists for your personal device. For example, WordLens is an app that has optical word recognition software, and Google is working on prototypes of hardware that can do real-time translation in controlled environments. And the giant telecom NTT Docomo has created augmented reality glasses that can take words on signs and menus and translate them in near real time. Now, real-time translation wouldn't just be useful when you're in Bora Bora and you need to ask someone the way to the bathroom. Preserving linguistic differences can benefit us in lots of ways. For example, we can learn what aspects of language are universal as opposed to peculiar to a specific language. That there are some incredible similarities between human language and the languages of dolphins and whales. Now, this suggests that there are some elements of language that are universal across species. So the question is this just restricted to Earth's species? Well, maybe in the future we'll have access to something like the Babel fish from The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. It was a little fish that you would shove into your auditory canal and it would actually excrete translated alien languages directly into your brain. But whether it's communicating with aliens or animals or humans, there's some things that are always going to be lost in translation. Now here we're talking about noise. Not just literal noise, which can interfere with communication, but psychological factors, like assumptions that we make about a person based upon their life experiences right when we get into a conversation that can impede real communication. There's so many different ways communication could go haywire. Frankly, I'm surprised we ever managed to communicate in the first place. And some things are impossible to communicate. For example, the feeling you get when you listen to Mozart, or when you wake up from a bad dream, or how it feels to fall in love. But that doesn't stop us from trying. I've got a question for all of you. What application can you imagine for real-time translation devices? Let us know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure you like it and subscribe to our channel and share it around with your friends. And oh, don't forget to check out these videos over here. They're pretty awesome, but that one in particular, that one's really, really good.